What's up?
What's going on,
Joe?
Good
to see you, brother.
Thank you for having me, man.
So we were just talking about injuries, like the life of a fighter. Yeah. So you always have something wrong, right?
Yeah, it's rough. Like, especially for someone me, like I'm getting a little bit older now and I'm being smarter, but like I was training, I still kind of do like almost three times a day. So like I would do a morning skill session, an afternoon run or an afternoon strength session, and then another skill session at night. And I did that for 10 plus years. So, but I love it though. So I'm finding now, like trying to find that balance of like, if it's a hard morning, like MMA, like sparring session, nighttime will be jiu-jitsu and I'll try to make it light. But you know how that, like you drill, then right. You start rolling. And when you're rolling hard, it's almost just as, I get injured sometimes more during jiu-jitsu. So
the whole rolling light is,
it doesn't happen.
Never happens.
I was telling my wife, cause my hand, I was coming out here. I was like, maybe I can go and I can just like drill with Gordon and those guys. She was like, you ain't fucking drilling with no, if you guys start rolling light, like there's not going to be any of that. And I'm like, you're 100% right. So yeah.
That's smart though. That's smarter Sean, like older.
100%. And that's where like before I'd be like, nah, fuck that. Like I'm going to go hard and then I'd be injured and then I wouldn't be able to fight. So
the problem with injuries is if you don't give them respect, they get chronic. If there's so many guys that have an injury and they try to train through it and it just gets worse and worse and worse.
Yep.
And then instead of being out for 6 weeks, now you're out for 6 months.
And that was me after my Bilal fight. So I came home from Abu Dhabi. I didn't have any injuries. I wanted to get back and I wanted to get that taste out of my mouth. So I'm back training, I'm back running, and then I start to feel that pain I was telling you about. And I literally just kept running. Like I'd run once I was warmed up. Like, you know how it is. You warm up, the injuries kind of go away. Like you feel good until you cool down. And I did that for a couple months and I had a fight scheduled and I tore my groin. And then I rescheduled the fight. I did my rehab and the first week back of training, it tore again. So it was a shitty road.
Have you had any surgeries?
I had my deviated septum done. Obviously, they didn't fix the outside because this shit's fucked up. But besides that, like, I broke my thumb. I never had knee, never had any. I've been pretty lucky with no surgeries, but a lot of injuries.
Isn't the deviated septum one amazing?
When I got it done, when you have to have those things in your nose for a week, though, as soon as they pull them out, you feel like a new human.
It's like
oh, it's the best.
It's incredible.
It's the best.
I never knew like how much cardio I was missing, not being able to breathe out of my nose. Look at like Dreykus.
Yeah.
Like Duplessis. Yeah. When he got his nose fixed, like he used to always fight with his mouth open and people thought he was out of shape.
Yeah.
And the guy just can't breathe out of his nose.
I think at some point though, you have to open up your mouth, obviously. Like, but I do all my zone two now on the echo bike, mouth closed. Like, and now I just started doing mouth tape when I sleep. My recovery on like my Oura Ring went through the roof.
Just from mouth tape.
Just from mouth tape. Yeah.
You use like hostage tape?
I had this one called Dream that I got, but hostage, it's the same
thing.
Does
it fuck with you with the mustache though?
No.
Sometimes if I have like too much facial hair, it doesn't stick that good.
My buddy Simon was saying that because he had some like cheap one. He was like, doesn't it bother you when you pull it off? I'm like, yeah, a little bit, but
no, I don't mean that. I mean it doesn't stick good.
Oh no, these ones they stick good. Like you have to pull it off. Yeah, the cheap ones just fall right off. Mm. Like I'd wake up and it'd be like on my fucking shoulder.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
But
that's interesting that it had that much of an impact on your recovery.
Yeah.
So you wear an Oura Ring.
Yeah.
And like, so what is my wife wears one of those, but I've never worn it. Like, how does it work? Like, what is the what's the metrics it gives you?
So I used to have Whoop, and Whoop couldn't. Like I was getting
tattoos.
I couldn't shoot through my tattoos.
Yeah.
So I'd get inaccurate readings on all my shit. And I actually like messaged them and they're like, hey, like it's just the kind of lighting we have. Like, so I would wear it here, but then it would go up on my wrist and then on my, like I have nowhere I could wear it. So this was like the next best thing. But it does the same. It does HRV, heart rate, your sleep, deep sleep, REM. It tracks your workouts, but like I really don't care about that. Like if I'm going to track my workouts, I wear the Polar or like the MyZone. So I'll wear those. But it does your sleep, does your does a lot of things. And
I got a new one, Morpheus.
I have Morpheus. Train with Morpheus. I have Morpheus,
the
too.
The app is outstanding, too.
I have Morpheus.
I really like that
You do the HRV in the morning and stuff like that. Yeah. I love buying them, and I just try them. And I, like, compare them. Like, I'll wear everything, and I'll do the Echo Bike workout, and I'll compare, like, my heart rates and stuff like that. So, yeah, it's fun. But when I got my nose fixed, it was a game changer for sure.
Yeah, it's just such a different thing to be able to breathe out of your nose. But it's interesting to me that the sleep, that your recovery is better. I just always wonder why.
Yeah.
Why breathing through the nose while you sleep improves your recovery?
Well, I'll snore. Like, if I sleep on my back, my wife will hit me, and she's like, "You're fucking snoring." I'll turn on my side, and I won't snore anymore. And then I added the mouth tape, and I just started doing no THC, but just CBD gummies, and... My wife, too, she's a nurse. She's, like, getting the best fucking sleep she's ever had. Our deep, because you can see the deep sleep on there. I have the 8 sleep mattress, too.
I have that,
so
too,
I can, like, compare it. And our deep sleep is from the CBD for me, and the mouth tape is through the roof. Wow. She doesn't do the mouth tape, but she does the CBD, and our deep sleep is great.
That's interesting. So, like, does it give you a score? And, like, what is your score that you get?
So, it will give you, like, can I pull my phone out?
Sure. Yeah.
Like, I posted one the other day.
So here it is. Jamie's pulled it up here. So it shows you readiness. So time to recover is 44. That's me today for sure. Train carefully is 75. And then good day ahead is 96.
Was my one when I wore the mouth tape and the CBD.
Okay.
My heart rate was 38.
Optimal. Yeah, that's great. No, that's awesome.
And it, like, usually my deep sleep doesn't get as deep.
Mm. Resting heart rate 38 is pretty fucking low, dude.
Yeah, especially not for in camp. Not bad.
That's great.
Description of what makes it maybe a little different.
It says each person a unique version of normal, rather than your base averages on impersonal population benchmarks like hit 10,000 steps. Aura gets to know you and provides you with personalized baselines and insights. Whether your sleep took a hit after a night out or you're prioritizing balance in your wellness routine, Aura helps you reach your goals by delivering the best 360-degree view of your health.
Yeah. I like it, but can't wear it during MMA practice or anything like that, so I'll take it off. But I was getting almost too caught up with the Whoop, because, like, you wake up when you're in a training camp, like, you're most likely going to be in the yellow or the red. You know, like, you're not always going to be in the green. Then it's, like, telling you to take it easy. It's like, I fucking can't take it easy. I have a fight So you have to find the balance of knowing, like, I actually really feel like shit, or this thing's just telling me I feel like shit.
It's really funny, that balance between, like, especially when someone's just completely obsessed. Like, I was listening to this or watching this video where Craig Jones was talking about when he was training, especially when he's first starting out, he was training every day.
Yeah.
And he went to a doctor, and the doctor's like, you, like, might have cancer. Like, you might have a serious illness.
Yeah.
Like, what's wrong with your body?
Yeah.
And it really was just that he was just worn out. Yeah. He was completely overtrained.
Yeah. And